Hey everyone, it's Josie. So today I'm going to do a mast cell update because I haven't done one yet and I don't know why I haven't done one yet, but I didn't and now I'm going to do one today. For starters, one of the reasons I went to the allergist is because I was having really bad gut reactions to things. Also, my face was constantly red. I was randomly getting rashes. Not only was I having reactions to pretty much everything, I literally thought that I was allergic to everything, but I also lost a lot of weight. I couldn't really eat anything. That's where I ended up kind of getting diagnosed with mast cell activation syndrome. I did get the blood work done. The blood work did come back negative, but it turns out that a lot of people with mast cell activation syndrome don't have positive blood work. Positive blood work is usually very common, usually in people with mastocytosis, which is a different form of a mast cell disease. So mast cell activation syndrome does not really require the 100% positive blood test, because, you know, all your levels could be perfectly normal, and then the second you eat or go near something, all of a sudden it's like, whoa, and then your body hates you. Yeah. So even whenever I started on the medicine for mast cell, I still stuck to my dietary things that I kept with. So I was still dairy-free and egg-free, as well as watching soy and corn. Of course, staying away from potatoes, because I'm actually allergic to potatoes. I even was starting to react to meat, so I took out meat from my diet and was only having it every once in a while. I used to have an issue every once in a while with wheat. I would have to go gluten-free for like several months, and then I would be fine for a while. Then I'd have to go gluten-free for a few months again. So I know I was like tested for celiac, I was tested for wheat allergy, and we kind of just tossed it up as being like it might just be a mast cell reaction because it's not an intolerance, because it's not affecting me all the time. The mast cell reaction that I used to get is it used to be like a gut reaction, which it recently switched from no longer being a gut reaction but to a migraine. I was actually able to gain back all the weight that I lost, which was interesting because I was actually able to eat things. Really good parts of me doing what I'm doing, because I'm on the H1 and H2 blockers, so it was cetrazine that I'm still taking, but H2 blockers, we've switched 5 different times. I'll go over that in a second. Singular, so I was also taking that as well. And then, of course, my asthma medicine, because I am asthmatic. So I'm taking those things, so it has helped a lot. My face is not red all the time, which is quite amazing. My face used to be flushed all the time, and we couldn't really do anything about it. Sometimes it would end up going up to here. Not getting hives as often or rashes as often as I was. Something else I've kind of learned from mast cell is even with the medicine, there's still a 50-50 shot of having a reaction to things. I try to keep all of my stuff as natural as possible, even if I have to make it myself. I have gone over before that because of mast cell, I have chosen to kind of get rid of a lot of like beauty-ish related products, even normal everyday items. I made that video a little bit ago saying that I do make my own lotion. I now make my own soap, make my own lip balm. I still wear makeup every once in a while. It's fine and I don't react to any of it. I no longer use face wash. I now just kind of make my own. I do use Schmidt's deodorant. I use Tom's fluoride-free toothpaste, and I usually just make my own. And then my laundry detergent, I use 7th generation, but the kind that is like the powder that comes in the pouches. We'll be at some point switching to soap nuts, which if you've never heard of those are really interesting. You should look them up. It's like a great hypoallergenic way of cleaning your clothes, so I will be switching to them soon. I just try my best to stay away from anything that I think I might react to. H2 blockers kept getting switched. That's where I'm going to get into the next thing. I've always had stomach problems my entire life. As time went on, I've had issues with like food and my stomach hurting and then not feeling good after I ate. And I could control it for a while and was able to go on this like plant-based diet I was on for a while, and it was going really good, and out of nowhere like it just crashed and burned, and the past few months have been insane. I've lost all of my weight plus more. Finally decided to go and see a GI doctor. I had to get a gastric emptying scan done. I'm getting an endoscopy done. I was able to go in there and kind of like state things, and they immediately were like, well, there's a lot of stomach issues that are quite common in EDS, so we're gonna be looking for those. So anyways, that's pretty much the update for mast cell. Things have gotten better. The medicine is working quite well. Yeah, mast cell is so complex. Like, I did not realize. I'm going to definitely make an update about, I don't know, whatever happens with all of these tests in hopes of any answer. That is why I have not put out any videos recently, is because I've been extremely exhausted. We'll just see how this rest goes. Also, if you have mast cell, is there anything that you just kind of stick to? Do you stick to a low histamine diet? What do you do to help it out? I know some low histamine diets are helpful and sometimes it's not. Have you found anything that helps? I've been hearing a lot of people about vitamin C. I'm definitely gonna try that. I would love to find natural ways to help control this. So anything that even you guys have found naturally to take that has helped, I would love to know, because I'm not someone who likes medication because of the potato allergy. I hope you guys have a good day and a good week, and I will see you soon. That was really weird. I don't know what this was. Okay, bye.